All right, so we are done with free agents. We are going to be talking about some events that took place over the weekend. Once again, this is Bizarro Mike. Do you want me to call you Vanilla Steve? Vanilla
no,
Steve?
No flavor.
And Tasty Steve, a.k.a. Tasty Jam. Tasty Jam, all right? So say Jam and Tasty Steve.
Right. Whatever you say.
Go. So, events just happened this weekend. Did anyone here actually get a chance to catch any of the Kakomp Arena event?
I didn't get to catch a lot of it because
that was the Brazil tournament.
That was the Brazil tournament.
I didn't catch like all I saw was like results. So,
okay,
yeah.
Okay.
I saw a decent amount of it.
Oh, okay, cool, yeah. I mean, it was a situation here where it was mostly local players, but the foreign players that traveled there were K-Brad and Justin Wong.
Right.
And, you know, us here in the U.S. are used to having foreign players come and take all of our points and spots and prize money. But apparently, Justin and K-Brad got sick of that and wanted to see what it felt like.
First and second. Yep. Yeah, they went in there and did work. Yeah,
yeah. So let's take a look at the results here. So tied for seventh place, we've got Argirath using Nekali and CDA, Didymo KOF using Dalsum. Mm-hmm. We have in fifth place, SOA Death Gun using Ryu and Innova Kaoma with Karen in fifth place. Fourth place was SOA Brolinho with Nekali.
Whoa, now.
Third place was, we had to do commentary with Master Vader on stream, okay? And that didn't go well. Okay, FCBR, Rob KOF with Birdie in third place.
His
second
Birdie
place.
Was sick. Yeah, it's impressive.
Oh, yeah?
The
okay,
Birdie player?
Okay.
Yeah, it was really good.
Cool.
And he knocked Kaoma
into losers.
Oh, he was the one who got into winners finals versus Justin, right? Okay.
Yeah,
he was the only one that took a game off of Justin. Justin basically went undefeated in games except one, and it was that Birdie player, huh?
Yeah, it was pretty... He was pretty solid.
Yeah, second place, EG K-Brad.
Didn't he get a perfect the first round?
He did get a perfect on Justin,
yeah.
And then first place was, of course, EG Justin Wong. So what did you think of the competition that was there in Brazil?
I thought, well, particularly the Birdie player was really good.
Rob
but I was impressed. The play was good. I mean, Justin and K-Brad did well, but, I mean, Justin's been doing well at Premier Events in general, right? Third at NCR. He's looked good so far. Every time I see him play, he's better. But, man, his Karen combos are still... He does, like, the undroppable combos, you know?
Yeah.
He does, like, the 100%ers instead of, like, the extra 100 damagers, you
know?
But you can't beat good footsies.
And you know
like,
what?
You
to
know.
Be honest, even remember when he first played Killer Instinct, he didn't care about damage.
That's
he just
true.
Did the shortest combos
possible.
He
actually invented... how to play KI.
Really?
So in KI, like when you're in the corner, you do wall splat,
uh-huh,
and then you do throw or neutral jump.
Right.
That's a Justin Wong invention.
Yeah.
Really?
Like a lot of the KI mix-ups and everything that's not like the combo system, Justin invented. Was
that's
like,
true.
Here's how you play this game.
Interesting.
So yeah, he was
all about
all right.
Like resets.
But,
I remember that.
The reason why I like that though is because I always tell people a lot of the times that people are always like, I can't be good unless I learn all the hard combos,
unless
I learn the crazy execution. Yeah, Justin would do the one-frame Rufus combos and stuff like that.
You have
to. But he dropped combos like a mofo,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
I mean, the EG special, right?
Yeah.
The Rufus doing EX.
Yeah,
okay, it happened to Ricky like maybe once or twice, but let's face it. It was Justin who that happened to most, right?
Right.
You can be a top player without having ridiculous execution.
That's true.
He's totally proof, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And that's one of the things that I like about it. And Street Fighter V, honestly, I feel like kind of suits that style a little better than most other games.
Oh,
right, yeah.
Because Street Fighter IV, it was, you had all those crazy Vortex setups, and, you know, you did have some crazy one-frame FADC combos, but I feel like Justin can play Street Fighter V how he wants to play it.
Yeah.
I mean, dude, he dropped all those combos against Tokido at NCR. Otherwise, he would have beat Tokido.
Yeah, right? That's the problem, right? But
he beat
Mago's.
No,
Karen.
He beat,
yeah.
And Mago's Karen does all the fancy stuff.
Mago's
Karen
the
is
hard
like,
stuff.
He's like doing the instant tenkos
and
like all the. So Mago's Karen is like maximum difficulty execution mode. I don't drop stuff. But Justin just plays footsies and wins. So it's like, all right, well.
Justin did talk about on Yahoo Esports with Travis Gafford about how he essentially just melted down after that
loss.
Second game, within the third game,
where he dropped on.
And he started dropping combos, and it just was all down.
Oh, yeah, you could totally see it.
Yeah.
And it's funny, too, because what I had mentioned on commentary is that was actually the Wong factor. So a lot of people call
it's
the
like
Wong...
the opposite of
that. What happened now is that the Wong factor, Justin explained before a long time ago in an interview at Evo, that it was actually the Wong factor was people dropping combos on him that were going to kill him.
Right.
It's since then morphed into now he has comeback power because he's Justin Wong. That's the Wong factor. The original was that people would drop combos on him because when they hit him, they would get so nervous.
Yeah.
Like, oh, gotta do the combo. And then they drop it, and then Justin would make the comeback. And he literally Wong factored himself against Tokido once he dropped that combo. So that's really unfortunate. So... But they did play some other games at Kakop Arena. And shout-outs to that whole team, by the way. I've been in communication with a lot of them. They're really cool guys. The event, the pictures that I saw looked really, really nice.
They did.
So they played Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Seventh place was Brian Kasugano, and Mr. Pato. So Brian used Chun-Li, Ryu, Akuma, as well as Beautiful Joe, Raccoon, and Arthur.
Oh, wow, that's a team.
Yeah, that's funky.
And Mr. Pato went with Magneto, Virgil, Dante. Mm-hmm. Fifth place, tied, was FCBR Ramon with Frank West, Trish, and Wesker. This is why David does this usually, okay? Mm-hmm. And FCBR Rob KOF, the birdie player. Nova, Spencer, and Strange. Fourth place was Bruno Jam with Storm, Morgan, Chun-Li. Third place, EG K-Brad with Trish, Virgil, Dante. And second place was Acido with Magneto, Dormammu, Doom, as well as Morgan, Doom, Magneto. First place, Justin Wong with Wolverine, Storm, Akuma.
I caught a little bit of Marvel. It was pretty good.
How was it?
It was pretty good, actually, overall. Yeah, I didn't get to see a ton of it, but I saw Justin win. So
That
happened.
Because I remember when I watched the recent Europe tournament and their Marvel players, I don't know, didn't look very...
It was very spotty.
Yeah.
I watched it myself. It was
saw it too? Yeah. Okay. Because last week I said that and everyone was like, damn, shots from James,
No, I'm going to tell you right now.
I got backup now.
I watched it, I was like, oh, let's see how this works out. Because, you know, I know of a couple of the, you know, Europe players, and I was like, this... It's going to be good. It's been a year, you know? And I'm like...
So that was what? Hype spotting?
I was hype spotting.
I was hype spotting.
Okay, so Ultra Street Fighter 4, seventh place was AAG. I'm going to guess it's Preda, P-R-3-D-A, Preda with Rolento. And AAG, Baby Brazil with Rufus.
Baby Brazil.
Fifth place, PvP, CFC, Tama with Rose and Guy, and Young Tan with Cammy. Third place, wow, you can see the Kaoma influence here. Yeah. Fourth place is SOA Trajano with Abel. And third place was SFT Dark, also with Abel. Second place, SOA Brolinho with Oni and Ibuki. And first place, EJ K-Brad with Cammy and C Viper.
I guess Justin probably didn't answer Shuba.
Yeah,
before,
maybe Kaoma did not enter either.
I would assume not. Yeah.
Right.
Dead game, right? Like no one plays anymore or whatever.
Yeah.
I keep hearing that. It's so funny.
It's seriously once Street Fighter V started getting like steam, it's like everyone was like, I really like Street Fighter V, and Street Fighter IV just really.
Well, you know what happens, right? So it's a Tekken thing. That once a Tekken game comes out, no one plays any other Tekken games that come after it. And that's exactly what happened.
You mean before, right?
Well, before,
yeah.
So it's like if once Tag 2 came out, nobody played like six or anything like
that. Yeah, so someone said Kaoma did not enter.
So it's one of those things. And I mean, I feel like it's the smart thing to do, but on the same note, it makes it easier transitional.
it's hard to go back and play the other game.
You had a lot of people that were, you know, talking about how they wanted to keep Ultra alive on Twitter and whatnot, and come to find, you know, like they didn't think they would like Street Fighter V, and come to find out.
That's true.
They
I think that's the big reason,
And I also remember when K-Bread actually tweeted, he was like, oh, Cammy, I can't play Cammy in Street Fighter 4
that's
anymore.
Why he's playing
I'm not going to see Viper all the way
through.
Yeah.
So it's like,
I turned it on, I was like, what is he doing?
Yeah.
they must have the names.
No, honestly, yeah, it's so hard, because once you start learning one thing with one Cammy, then it's kind of tough to go to the other
one.
So,
that's true.
Yeah. But, I mean, look, the money is all in Street Fighter V as well, right? So that's where a lot of players are going to go. Mortal Kombat X. Fourth place was ARC Batista with Mystic Ermac. Pecky, I guess.
Good luck.
P-E-Q-U-I with Sandrim with Cryomancer Sub-Zero and Unbreakable Sub-Zero. Second place was Marcus VSM with Swarm Queen Devorah, Shotgun Jackie Briggs, and first place was Poto with Brawler Cassie Cage.
And Brawler is so good now.
Is she?
Yeah, Brawler Cassie is the business.
They buffed a little bit, right?
Yeah, Brawler Cassie is better. It's the version now to play, I think.
So better than... Which one was the one that Sonic Fox played all the
time? Sonic played Hollywood, mostly in tournament, but also Spec Ops. And he still does play Spec Ops, but yeah.
Oh, really? Over Hollywood?
Yeah.
Oh, that's crazy.
Well, because before, right, if you hit somebody high on the body with back one and a nut punch, you were plus on regular on regular nut punch, but they changed it. A lot of people aren't always playing Hollywood now, but yeah, she got some nerfs, but current version of Cassie is much...
Brawler Cassie.
It's more interesting, yeah. Okay. Brawler Cassie is more interesting.
So with Guilty Gear Xrd Sign, fourth place was Landstalker with Axel, third place PLSX with Elfelt, second place FCBR Nightmare with Leo and Axel... First place was FTLTR Trema with Chip Zanuff.
Yeah, a lot of people playing the Chip versus Leo and Axel Lowe. Yeah, that's a done deal. Like, that's really hard.
But, for who?
It's really hard for those two characters.
Oh, okay, so Chip is a counter character.
Chip moves so much faster than, like, Leo that his moves are very committal. It's like, I'm doing this button. And Chip is like, so you're going to do that. Well, I'm going to jump over here, and then he's going to hit you, and that's kind of how
teleport YRC.
That's exactly how you play that matchup in a lot of instances. Okay. And I saw, like, the tail end of that.
Now, is that match really bad, or are you just saying that because you're a Leo player?
Well, I was a Chip player. It's just, I can tell that it's really hard. If you don't know that matchup, it's a lot harder to deal with Chip.
Okay. But, of course, Revelator's coming out. We'll talk a little bit about that. So, that's what happened this past weekend. I don't remember. Was there anything else? I know Street Fighter Crash happened.
I watched that.
And that was the Team Topanga won that, right?
Okay, so they're doing, like, it's like a four-week event of, like, pools. And each pool has different teams in it.
Right.
And yeah, Topanga got this one. The first one, I think, their first match, like, Momochi OCV'd. And then he got...
Rip Kayla, Korean Kayla players.
Wait, but you guys have seen the Tekken Crash series, right?
Yeah, I've actually never seen
it. It's essentially the same.
Right,
it's the
same thing. Yeah, but now they're doing it for Street Fighter 5.
And the commentators had matching outfits. It was the cutest thing.
You two should do that.
Dude,
never, ever, ever.
Me and Steve have a different
dress code.
Yeah.
Dude, whenever me and David showed up, like, because we don't even consult each other when we talk about ties and shirts and stuff. And there are days where, like, we show up and we match and we're just like, oh, boy.
Yeah. It's just the worst. Yeah, you don't want to look. Like, Rip and I both wore red sweaters, the Wednesday Night Fights ones. And, like, you can take a sweater off. So it's not so bad, but it was, like, it was cold in there, you know? Yeah. So we're like, but I never again. Matching commentary is a bit... And they look like they were, like, prison outfits almost, right? They had, like, the stripes and everything. Yeah. I was like, you gotta get out of those.
A dark tie.
Yeah.
they didn't look happy either.
No. You know? I felt bad for them. Yeah. I was like, man, I got you wearing these matching outfits.
One guy was like, you know, let's get hype. And it's totally, like, that fake, like, trying to hype up the chat.
Oh, that is the worst.
Dude, and I saw, like, the lights so in there. I would have been blinded. By all the lighting and all the esportsy glow lighting that was going on in there, I think that's cool.
Though. Like, I love the fact, I like the crash event itself.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
I'm in love with that. Yeah, like, I love the fact that they make it such a spectacle and it's still the highest level of play, but you only get one match.
Yeah. Oh, so dude, that the game was like somebody was just like boom, boom, done. Yeah. Like two rounds straight.
Especially Street Fighter V.
Yeah, it was like 20 seconds. I was like, oh my god.
But it was the Laura player. It was like something eight. Oh my god. It was a Laura player in the Street Fighter Crash. And I was telling people about it because I was watching it at work and I was like, you guys need to watch what he was doing.
Yeah. I think I saw some of that.
He lost. I can't even remember who he lost to, and I definitely need to check it out. If somebody's in the chat and remembers, please feel free to let me know. But he did some amazing stuff with Laura, like every the ambiguous cross up with the oh my, it was so good.
Oh, yeah.
Like I wish I could just pull up this video, but it was really good. Like
and it was also some of the most Momochi footage I've seen.
Oh, that's right.
Because we haven't seen a ton of Momochi Ken.
Yeah, I know Momochi has been having trouble with a lot of... Is it June 8 Park? Was that it? Or
June 8, I think it was, yes. Okay, I'm almost certain that's it. Thank you so much.
But, I mean, I heard Momochi's been having character crisis in this game. Who was he using?
He was playing Ken. Oh, so, before, like, the last tournament he was at, what was it? NCR?
Yeah, he was
playing Chun, right?
He played both Chun and Ken.
So I heard he's been... I've seen him switch to playing different characters and stuff, but...
I mean, I talked to...
Other Ken players are having success. So.
Yeah. I mean, look, Ken is a different character than what he's used to now,
he's
right?
Very
Ken
different.
Is a little crazier now, right?
I talked to Chris T about that at last Wednesday Night Fights. And
right.
We were all talking about it because they were talking about teams for an upcoming tournament.
Yeah, and they couldn't... do the same character.
But, yeah, so...
All Ken players on the...
Exactly,
right.
But... I'm not even going to do that. I'm not going to spoil it. Anyways.
Yeah.
Okay.
But they were talking about how different Ken is.
Yeah.
And anybody who remember talking to Chris T, he is quoted saying, like, yo, I don't like Ken.
Yo,
I don't like
Ken. He's garbage. He's, like, the worst character.
And now he's just like, yo, I love Ken, bro. Like, that's what he says in the voice. I love Ken, bro.
Like, that's very Chris Tatarian.
To be honest with you, I think that Ken suits Chris's style a lot.
Oh, yeah.
Chris was a little more aggressive, and he likes the style a little bit more.
Yeah.
And that's less Momochi style. I mean, I've heard that he's been thinking about going with Karen, and I think that's a perfect choice for Momochi.
I've seen him play Karen already, but I could be wrong.
I feel like you're right. I feel like
he's played Karen,
whether it's a stream or something. But yeah,
I'm sure he's tried all the characters, probably. Yeah.
Because he's done, like, character breakdowns.
Yeah, he has the series where he talks
about.
They're
all right.
But,
I mean, I know, they're so good. His lectures are ridiculous. I'm, like, watching them, and I'm like, oh, my God.
Got your notepad out.
But see, here's the thing. To be fair, you try to keep yours concise to, like...
His are pretty long.
Yeah, his get pretty long. You try to... You're, like, the kindergarten version of the tutorials.
He's like the eight minute ad. The difference is
I have to break it down for American FGC, which is like kindergarten, you know, but he's making it for Japan FGC, so it's gotta be like, it's like university, you know, they're like university tier, and I'm breaking it down for the kindergarten.
Wow.
No, but and honestly, my versions are super basic because, you know, they're not supposed to be advanced.
Shots fired. Be triggered.
Well, after this commercial, we will no longer have Sejam.
It's been good.
I will throw him out.
Yeah, but I think it's a very different. It's a very
banned from the Discord.
What Discord? Wait.
Are you not in the Discord?
Is there a Discord? Are you talking about the secret tech Discord?
Yeah, the.
Oh, that sounds like
one Discord.
It sounds like a bunch of kindergarten stuff, dude. I'm not about that.
Wow.
No, but yeah. I am impressed with the work that he puts into his content.
Yeah.
There's like no player that level doing that kind of content.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Well, I mean, look, he's trying to make a whole business out of it. Like, he's literally...
He has like his shinobi school thing that he's like teaching kids.
Him
and
Choco, they're trying to teach people how to be esports athletes, basically. Yeah.
But you know the other part of them doing that, because they're not the only ones. That's kind of why Daigo does his stream. Some of the stuff I alluded to earlier with Bonchan doing... Japan doesn't have that younger generation of players.
Oh, they don't have any follow-up. This is just,
they don't have the 19-year-old, 20-year-old, like the knuckle dudes.
That's true. That's true.
And Sejams.
The Sejams.
Oh my God.
Their last generation of players are like the, you know, the 26 to 28-year-olds. Like the, Bonchan's actually one of like that last generation of players that's come in.
And it's funny that you said it. I've never thought about that. That there's no... Now, what's crazy was, in Tekken, like, in Japan, there are some young players that are up-and-coming. But now that I think about it, there's no Street Fighter up-and-coming players.
That's why they're working with younger...
It's even funny. Beansy in the chat was like, I've seen them in Tekken, but
not
for other
games.
Yeah,
no, it is. In Tekken, they vet these guys, and they play, and they're not even, like, good. They're ridiculous.
Yeah.
So I think it's amazing, and I swear I've never thought about that until you just said it. Man, that is crazy.
That I talked to... both Bonchan and Tokido about it, like around EVO and TGS, because I noticed that, wow, there really aren't any of those young players, and that's why all those guys want to do more to try to bring the game to younger players.
That's right. Video games are an old man thing.
Yeah. In Japan, I mean, maybe. I don't know.
So, in I remember last year, it was one of the last CPT qualifying events. I know Mike Ross was there. He played it, and it was Ultra Street Fighter 4 tournament. And I was looking at those guys, and they had a few, and this was in, I think it was the Korean one. Could be wrong, but I could be wrong.
Was it Tokyo Game Show, maybe?
Yeah, it might have been TGS. Was it TGS? I know Mike played in TGS, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But it was one before that, and Jace the Ace was there as well.
No, I don't think so.
Oh.
Yeah.
For sure. I know Mike. He didn't play
TGS, but it was one before that.
It was the TGS before that, then, where he played against Kazunoko first round.
The last TGS Mike didn't.
Yeah. Okay. So I remember he played Kazunoko first round at a TGS once. And it was like last hit.
Yeah.
Was like,
I remember.
First to one. Or single limb. That's how it goes.
But, yeah.
But it's interesting to think about that because we've always looked at Asia and Japan, especially, as that scene that we've always looked up to, we always, you know, they were always on top and kind of still
are. They're strong scene.
They don't have that young generation
that
the West did, you know, Europe and U.S. Right. And I guess, you know, like South America also. Those guys came in with, you know, Street Fighter 4 and Ultra Street Fighter. Knuckles didn't even start playing Street Fighter 4 until I think it was Arcade Edition.
Yeah. We have our Knuckle Dude and our Chris T and our Filipino man.
No, we
have,
like, think about it like this. We have a generation that's set to keep going.
Right, exactly.
Even when Valle stops playing, Chris T will be getting to the point where Justin is right now. You know what I mean? So
that's crazy.
No, I'm just kidding.
That's crazy to think about.
I never thought about that.
I mean, even in China, right? Shaohai, Shenzai, Busu, Shaohai.
Right, that's what I always say.
Exactly.
Yeah, dude.
I say it five times before I go to bed, you know? Like, all right, I got you.
No, Shaohai, of course, his nickname is the child, the kid.
How old is he?
And he's not a kid anymore, that way, so, yeah.
Sounds like an old nickname.
Oh, man. But, okay, well, so let's talk about some weekends that are, there's some events coming up this weekend.
All the events.
We have a SoCal tournament, oh my god, like, we never have any.
Right.
There basically is no SoCal tournaments except for SCR. But West Coast Warzone is coming back this year, Coast Warzone 5. That will be streamed by Level Up. So definitely check that out at twitch.tv. At twitch.tv, is it going to be streamed on the Level Up channel? I'm not sure if there's
a West Coast. I would assume so, right?
There might be a West Coast Warzone channel that they're being streamed
possibly.
On.
Possibly. I thought they had one last year for sure.
Yeah, I can't remember now. But but it's going to be streamed by the Level Up staff. A lot of players are going to be there.
It's like 10 minutes from my house. I'm so happy about this.
Oh, can I stay at your place?
I was about to say, I
know,
was that
right?
Close to the spot?
I'm so happy. It's right by the block, you know that? It's like literally right by
your place.
It's right by the block. Okay. You're going to be in town tomorrow, right?
I'm here through Monday.
Oh, wow. So you're coming to Wednesday Night Fights tomorrow.
So you're coming to Wednesday Night Fights tomorrow, right? To hang out with Steve and Steve. Yeah.
Yeah.
To hang out with Steve and
Steve. You gonna be there?
Yeah, you should go.
All right. In there.
I was gonna offer him dinner, and then he went and did all that. Oh, okay, you see how it is? We could have, you know, it could just be a real casual time, you know what I'm saying? But all right.
We could ask him questions and maybe try to. Nah, never mind. No one would read that.
I was gonna offer him dinner, and then he went and did all that. That's how you lose dinner. Just like that. Those are the step by step process.
Man, that was a fast 3-frame jab.
Yeah. All right, you got me good. Dinner's back on the table.
should be a fun event though. There's gonna be a lot of good players at West Coast Warzone.
All the games.
It's gonna be my first one.
Street Fighter 5, Ultimate, Marvel vs. Capcom 3, Guilty Gear Xrd, MKXL, and USF 4.
Sounds so good.
Run some old school games there.
They're having Revelator for Guilty Gear.
Yeah,
Revelator.
I asked them last
week. Oh, they're
going to
do it? Oh, so sick.
It's
going to
be
sick.
Revelator. That's going to be sick.
Man, that is so cool.
And I know there's. I think there's going to be an ST tournament there.
Revelator?
Am I entering or am I going?
You enter?
I'm not sure yet. I don't know if I'm going to pay that $80 door fee.
You don't want a pop monster?
I mean, I've been playing the crap out of that game. So, I mean. I don't know how free I would be.
Oh.
but I would love for somebody to try.
Oh, all right.
Oh, dude, I like the little eyebrow raise when you said that.
I am so about it.
Camera when you do.
I want you to try.
The tension here is too much. I'm not ready for the. Oh God.
I need practice, dude. We need to sit down.
No. We can definitely do that. We can definitely.
Well, also coming up this weekend is at the O'Hara Student Center at Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Is Fight Pit 6.
Mm-hmm. Go Pens.
This is going to be on twitch.tv/PGHNeoHSmash.
I remember that.
Again, FGCEvents.com/FGCEvents.
Is that really what it is?
It's FGCEVENTS.
Oh, that's the worst.
Because I think FGCEVENTS was taken already, so he had to change it to that. So you can check that there. But I think he also has FGC majors and another one, basically for different categories and different levels of detail. But this sounds like it's going to be mostly a Smash event. So check that out. Again, that's going to be in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Fight Nart. Fart Night Arkansas.
Sorry, John.
Fight Night Arkansas Season 1 Finale.
God, James.
It's going to be at Conway, Arizona.
Oh.
Arkansas, sorry. Arizona's AZ.
Jesus Christ. James. Man, David's not here one day.
Do you know what this is?
David is at his house just
hosted
his
by Panda X Gaming. Shout out to Panda X Gaming.
Panda X Gaming. They're going to be playing Pokken, Smash 4, SFV, Melee, MKXL, Project M, UMVC3, KI, and Exerd.
Okay.
You call it Pokken? You
don't say it? Is it Pokken or Pokken?
I say Pokken.
It's Pokken Tournament.
Man, James.
You know, I had a friend that used to call Tekken Tekken.
Oh, I heard
you
that
see
before.
Him? He literally shook.
Yeah.
When you said that, he literally... He went like that. Like
see that vein popping?
Oh, yeah. Pokken.
Sorry.
Pokemans Pokken. And...
They actually told us, to make sure we say tournament. You have to say Pokken Tournament.
Really?
That's what Nintendo told us.
Interesting. Yeah, if you guys don't know, Steve got to do the Pokken event in New York in the Nintendo store in New York.
That's why his Twitter is so PG.
Yeah.
So which Disney princess is your favorite?
Oh, man.
I'm a big fan of...
Hey, shots fired. Bang, bang.
Agrabah. Jasmine. That's my girl.
Okay. Jasmine, that's a good girl.
Your princess was a side lovely.
Oh, my God.
That's your jams. You guys...
We're going to do... Karaoke.
We're going to do
karaoke.
Disney
karaoke. You can be Jasmine. I'll be Aladdin.
NJ's Quarterly Rapport in Somerset, New Jersey. Going to be streamed on twitch.tv/DKZLive, as well as, that's where Street Fighter V and Exerd will be streamed. Melee singles and doubles will be streamed on twitch.tv/SigMelee, SIGMelee. Again, that is at Somerset, New Jersey. And finally, again, we mentioned it, Street Fighter V Crash, Street Fighter V Crash continues this weekend. You can watch the Korean stream on twitch.tv/crash_KR and watch the English stream on twitch.tv/crash_EN.
So this week is
Team Razor will be there.
Yeah.
It's Infiltration, Shen, and Fudo,
right?
Yeah.
They're on a team, yeah.
I think that's so sick.
That's a good team. Dude, they should just, like, seriously, if I was Fudo and Shen, I'd just be like, Infiltration, you go first. Then they wouldn't have to do anything.
Right, they don't have to play.
They just leave the venue and just like...
Hey, man, it's one game, though. Yeah.
It is one game.
That just means you're going to die to Infiltration that much
faster. I don't know, man. A Mika player shows up, starts hitting him with this. It might be over, man. You got to be
Get
careful.
Get these hands.
All it takes is one.
Hey, guess what we're going to talk about next, Steve?
We're
going to talk about some Killer Instinct.
What?
Now, so this is for upcoming events.
Right.
Ultra Arcade and Iron Galaxy Studio have unveiled details on the next Killer Instinct World Cup.
No way.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
What did they say? Tell me more, James.
Well, they said Season 3 is underway, and there's going to be a bunch of Combo Clash events.
Oh, you wouldn't happen to know that the first three events are Texas Showdown, Northwest Majors, and Combo Breaker. And I'll be at all three.
Wow, really?
You guys should know, yeah. You
okay,
guys
can
all those are qualifiers. Oh yeah, I'll be at all three coincidentally. Also, the Combo Clash events got announced, the overseas ones.
Yes, so CEO is going to be another one. Combo Clash San Antonio, Texas is going to be in August. 6th through 7th. Absolute Battle is going to be an event at Dallas, Texas. That's August 26th through 28th. Heart of Battle.
All in Texas.
In December, 2nd through 4th, will be in Houston, Texas. And then Kumite in Tennessee, January 6th through 8th in 2017 will be another location. And then Combo Clash Netherlands, Combo Clash France.
Wow.
Combo Clash Canada. And Combo Clash Community Choice.
Right.
Wow, that's a lot.
Don't forget possibly more.
Three question marks? Oh, no.
Now, I want to ask a question here.
I'm getting my passport ready.
We're calling them Combo Clash, right? But they're spelling it with Ks.
Right.
What's up with that? Is that a Mortal Kombat thing?
Killer Instinct starts with a K.
Killer Instinct.
Yeah, but I mean, Killer's not spelled with a C, right? But Mortal Kombat, like, it's proper to change it.
Killer is spelled with a K. Right. Spelled with a K.
But they didn't replace the
Combo Clash events are spelled with a K.
They didn't replace the C, but yeah, but James, Combo Clash, you've replaced the
just
C
like
with a K.
Just like Pawkins not spelled with a C, it's spelled with a K, James. It's simple here. You can figure this out.
I like how James holds it. He's like, make this make sense to me, guy.
Are you new here, James? Come on, man. You can figure this out.
Right, we've got some new game news coming up. All right. On the Street Fighter V front, fun stuff still happening there.
This is so great.
There is a glitch that people have discovered that makes it so that if you have the cursor defaulted to Alex, so he's selected as the previous player. And shout outs to Dentarian because, look, Tool Assisted tried to explain it on Twitter. I cannot understand a damn thing that guy
Tool Assisted is the worst. Everything he posts, when I'm trying to read it, I'm just like, what?
You can't
what
help
does
but,
this mean?
And you can't help but read it like, you see this? Yeah. LOL! Oh!
It's like
first grade grand, first second grade throw,
he's
LOL!
I need a Tool Assisted Rosetta Stone.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm trying to understand all the stuff he posts all the time, and other people are like, there, like, explain. All right, look, Steve, let me break this
yeah,
down.
Yeah,
you wouldn't believe what this yogi does.
Dude, I asked on Twitter, I'm like, I need a translator for Tool Assisted, because I can't understand anything he says. So.
I need like a translation section on Discord that's just Tool Assisted.
I know, right? All of his posts.
We need the Tool Assisted secret Discord translation Discord. That needs to happen.
I'd say we need a Parry account, but he's pretty much a Parry
account.
But the information is so good. Once you get through it and understand what he's saying, you're like, that's genius.
Once you disseminate
it. So Dentarian figured it out and explained it in English.
Right, not Tool Assisted.
Is that the characters have folders for version 1.01 and 1.02. By default, everyone's at 1.02 now. However, Alex only has one folder. So he's listed as 1.01. So when you default the cursor on him, it automatically chooses the 1.01 folder for every character once you even leave Alex.
Right.
So it loads the old versions of the characters. So then Mika's sweep is not throwable anymore again.
All the changes are reverted.
Right, and there wasn't that many, to be fair.
It was just small.
So do we know if this actually affected any, like, tournaments?
No, because Alex was never
Alex,
at any
tournaments. Yeah, he wasn't at any
He was at WNF.
He was at Wednesday Night Fights.
Like,
right.
No, Alex did well. So, I mean, maybe it affected stuff, but I don't know. Probably not.
In any case,
Capcom's great.
Hopefully they should fix
that
soon.
Did they do a patch, or was it just server maintenance today?
It's server maintenance.
It was server maintenance.
Yeah.
Just a middle of the day, normal 6-hour server maintenance, you know. Uh-huh. Like every game has. It's free to play on PC. Windows 10. Cross buy. You know the one.
You know the one.
Alright, anyway.
Anyways, yeah, it's unfortunate. Street Fighter V, but you know what? Again, we're finding these things early, so hopefully all the next characters won't.
It won't be a problem.
See, the thing is like they used that. That's why they had the updates in the arcades, because they could figure this stuff out, and then we would get a home version at some point. Well,
that's
now we're in a situation
where we're finding all of this stuff now. That's my thing. I don't understand why people are complaining so hard about anything like this, because we have a console exclusive game that we're able to play immediately, and there's no gaps in between.
Right.
You know, overseas and whatnot, et cetera, et cetera. Mm-hmm. This is what the arcade, it circumvents this because we don't have to worry about it. We get
right.
a finished product, all these things are taken care of. So I just say, yo, you got to eat it, man.
It's coming from Tekken / Guilty Gear fan.
Yeah.
Who has the, knows the real struggle
yeah.
of the arcade.
You guys don't even know. Yeah. Back in my day, it never came here. We had to buy it.
Every time Mortal Kombat did update, every time NetherRealm, well, I guess they were midway back then, did updates on Mortal Kombat, they would change all the fatalities and stuff in arcades. So you had to go find them all over.
Dude,
again,
the original MK3 when it first came out was so buggy.
There were so many because
they literally released a beta into the arcade, and everybody's fatality involved the run and the block button. Everyone's fatality was block, block, run, run, block. Or block, 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 block. Or run, block, block. Because they just hadn't set him yet. They didn't set him yet. And so literally new versions would get rolled out to arcades. And so they'd
change it all up.
So, I mean, honestly, the only bad part was that they marketed it as a full game. You know, if they had marketed, like, here's Street Fighter V, the arcade edition, you guys can start playing it versus now for $20. All the other content will come when you buy the $40 add-on. You know what I mean?
Like, Dead or Alive did. Dead or Alive made it so you can buy the standalone fighter. You can say, hey, I don't care about story mode. I don't care about any of this stuff. I just like the competitive part. Right. And you can buy it character by character basis, but just with a free client that you download. You can say, you know what? I don't really care about Ryu. I just want to buy Alex. You can do that.
Right.
But
that sounds like a great model.
Yeah.
Jesus.
What? I'm just impressed by the way that they're doing things. That sounds
good.
Shout out to Dead or Alive.
Yeah, Dead or Alive. Like just that game.
I want to see your reaction on this. There was a rumor that just came out today that Zappa might be coming back to Guilty Gear Revelator.
And I am not ready. Like, I'm not ready. It's just like, it's crazy because Daisuke came out and he said, he was like, hey, I eventually want all the characters in the game. Now, me personally, I got this thing, right, where I see a character and I'm like, hey, I have to play that character. And Zappa was that character back in the
game.
Was
it Tokido that...
Yeah, I actually beat Tokido at Final Round in Guilty Gear.
Really?
Yeah,
okay,
he was playing Zappa.
And what did he say?
He was like, best Zappa ever. I was like,
really?
Yeah. We were but like I said, I beat him.
That's
like,
nice of him.
Yeah, that was really nice.
Yeah. He needs a sponsor, by the way.
But it's one of those things that, like, you can't believe it now. Like, I'm like, he's back. It's like, you know, that long lost relative that thought he was dead. He's like,
right. So this is how I'm going to feel one day when Sodom gets announced for a shoot.
Oh, yeah. I'll be happy with
that. Best Sodom ever?
Did you see what Zappa looks like? He has, like, this messenger bag. Hang on a second.
So, the picture was so far just an in-game story shot, right? And that picture of the Zappa with the messenger bag and all that stuff was from the Guilty Gear Pachinko game from a long time ago. Because remember, Johnny was there, and he had this...
He had a beard.
He had the mustache. Yeah, like, really he had the real porn stash.
No, it was legit. It was like the character updates that they had for the Pachinko machine were all really, like, fleshed out.
I know, right?
And
dude, right? It was cool. So good. And, dude, like, the way you feel about Zappa... Like, I would just play Johnny for the first time on stream recently. I felt the same
you
way.
You should.
Because Johnny's so cool.
Sick.
His instant kill was so amazing. Oh, it was so good. Oh, my God. It was so good.
All I'm saying is, like you were saying.
Shout out to anime.
Like you were saying. It was from a story mode thing, but he was in there. I'm about to go in, guys. I'm going to be out of here. All right, here we go.
I'm about to explain why.
So, the picture that they showed is from a Famitsu article, but it was actually from story mode. But he was in story mode with another character that's not in the game named Dr. Paradigm. Now, the thing is about it, like you said, he was wearing that outfit.
Mm-hmm.
It was an alternate color, but it was definitely that character.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So... People are speculating, even though they haven't even announced it yet. Get out of here, man. even though they haven't actually put a date.
This cut is so deep right now. I'm bleeding out, dog.
Zappa is your dude, huh?
Dude. Zappa. Dude,
like, trust me, I know how you feel.
When
I got my hands on Johnny, dude, it was serious.
You feel like you're playing Guilty Gear again,
dude,
right?
Oh, my God. Like, I remember when I watched Karinchu videos, just watching Johnny move, I was just like, oh, Johnny. And so when I finally started to play him, and I was just like, I could feel the dash, the kick, heavy slash, misfinder. Except they changed the misfinder code, which is really screwing with me,
The fact that you call them codes, that's another thing. Drives me insane. It's a code? Is what it is? It's a code? I'm sorry.
You guys have never called
just,
a code?
No, you just turned on him like that?
That's such a bromance. They're like, John, he's like, Zappa. He's like, Johnny. He's like, oh man, I'm so excited. He's like, codes. He's like, what the fuck?
You just
a ghost.
It just threw me off. I just dove out of the car. A moving vehicle on the highway. I just hopped out. Just
bailed out.
But no. Woo. I was actually talking.
People used to get so mad at me. Like, everyone used to get mad at me when you have no health left. I always called it zero vital. And people are always
why are you trying so hard? Zero vital?
I'm trying to make zero vital happen. It's
why we called it that? Because in Street Fighter 2, when you won, you would get points for how much health you had left. And it said vital. And it would count down. Okay. But when you had no life left, there was zero vital.
No, there wasn't. There was no life left, James. Come on, man. Come on,
man.
Guys.
That would drive me insane. Zero vital? I'm like, what the hell is he talking about? I don't...
He's like, is it going to kill? No, he's left with zero vital. He's fine.
So apparently, from what Sanchez told me, there was a guy at FFA or something that played Third Strike, and he would say that it took blood. So he'd be like, yo, that combo took 75% blood. And I'm like... And this is from Sanchez.
It was probably James.
The whole time.
There's nothing wrong with calling it blood, man.
Yo, dude, that took like 50% blood, dude.
That does so much blood. You got to do the code for quarter circle, and then you get 50% blood.
And leave him at zero vital. Anyways, they also announced a new character for Blaze Blue.
Yeah.
I don't know. What version is this for, or what? I can't keep track with this game anymore.
The thing is about it is, like, this character is apparently it's going to be for the console. It's not going to be an arcade.
Okay.
And we do have Central Fiction here in arcades.
Where?
Round one.
Oh, yeah.
Round one, yeah.
The Nesca cabs, yeah.
Yeah, they have Nesca cabs and, you know. Shout out to round one. Anyways.
I don't know about all that. All right.
But, so it's going to be, I think her name's ES?
But it's spelled ES, and it literally stands for embryo storage.
Yeah. See?
Wow. What?
Yes.
Is that real? That's so anime.
I've been to a couple of clinics named embryo storage.
But see, what I joked about on Twitter was now they finally made a character for all the Twitter trolls.
True waifu.
The eggs, right?
That's true.
Embryo storage.
That's
there
true.
That
I don't know. How do you feel about Blaze Blue?
Look, that game... I can't keep track of it. It never felt right to me. Like, I couldn't... Like, I'm one of those Guilty Gear players that are like, the game doesn't feel right to me. Like, I don't know what it is about that game. It never quite...
So, I play a lot of games.
Uh-huh.
And I like Blaze Blue. Let me rephrase it. I liked Blaze Blue.
Okay.
The fact that they kept adding these characters, one. Two, that they made a lot of changes to these characters... With every version, mm-hmm. It's almost reminiscent of Mortal Kombat
right.
X.
I couldn't
right there.
Played Talkaka in the very first game, and then when they went to the second one, I couldn't even play it because everything was different all of a sudden.
And just imagine that happened to every game.
Right.
And you have these updates that come out so regularly. And as much as I like a lot of the characters, there's a lot that goes on in Blaze Blue, whether it be character and even with the engine. And keeping up with those changes, in my personal opinion, I can't do that.
The characters are so complicated.
There's so many. Dude,
I had somebody explain to me like one character, and I was like, what? There's like eight subsystems in the character, and I'm just like, oh, God.
Yeah. I mean, and there's a lot of tech in those games, but I'm sorry. Shout out to Embryo Storage.
But they're fun. They're fun games, yeah, but literally...
Jesus, man.
Apparently if you played the game she's from, like Blade X or something
like
that...
It's
like
a side story kind of anime thing.
Yeah,
but... Basically, you just click... It's a click adventure kind of...
But apparently they explain it, and embryos are something specific, like in their lore or something.
Somebody tweeted to me. I don't care.
Yeah.
So Johnny Zappa... Pachinko machine 100%, but point and click game for Blaze Blue, we're not about that.
I'm just saying they're trying too hard.
Johnny Zappa pachinko
game,
it's fine.
The pachinko
game
put that stash on Johnny. I was not a fan of the stash, dude.
But Johnny was coming back.
I was just happy that. Well,
I'm just making sure.
The pachinko machine came out before Exert. So when Exert came out and there was no Johnny, after I saw that Johnny was in the pachinko machine, I felt really baited and switched.
Yeah.
I was V-triggered.
And also, just to be clear, we talked about this, that... he's referring to the demo. Well, the demo for Guilty Gear XR Revelator, which is what you get when you pre-order and pay for the game. You get to download the demo. But the demo is basically just the arcade version that they're playing in Japan right now, because we don't have access to that currently yet. So we get this as, you know, I guess a practice thing before EVO, because otherwise we wouldn't get to play this game until...
Right.
And a lot of the tournaments are just using it now.
Yeah, so they
like,
use it.
West Coast Warzone's going to do it. Combo Breaker's going to do it.
Yeah.
And the thing about it is, honestly, it's not... I mean, they're not doing it for Steam because you could return games or whatever, but on PS4, once you buy it digitally, I don't think you could return
nope,
it.
There's no return.
You're done. So you're already paying for it. So they're like, whatever, here.
Here you go.
You're going to buy
it. Until we're done.
Fully working training mode or versus mode.
Fully working training mode versus mode. It has all the characters. It just doesn't have the DLC characters.
Right.
So it's pretty bare bones, kind of like Street Fighter V was. Mm-hmm. It's basically just that. It's just you don't get any kind of story mode.
It has more content than Street Fighter.
He said that. He said that. I didn't say that.
It has more
just making sure.
But it's a really good tool. It's an amazing tool.
Yeah, it's so awesome to have. And like I said, I know this is going to sound as bad as it comes out of it. It feels so good to get my hands on Johnny.
Yeah.
Like, seriously, it does.
It does. Mike's face. All right, if that's what you
want. Anyways, they announced more King of the Fighters 14 characters.
Oh, yeah.
They revealed the patches slot
they're
crossover.
This is the 11th teaser trailer.
Dude, they have one like every week now.
They're
well,
going to
you
be
know
on like 56.
They have. No,
by the
you
time,
know how many
man,
characters they have in KOF though, right?
Yeah, it's a ridiculous.
It's going to have over 50 characters. And I mean, I feel like it's only right that, you know, for those people who have never played 1, 2, and for those who actually care about the game, I think it's a neat little incentive.
The game also looks better every time I see it.
Yeah, you know what? I'm still
not should.
I'm still gonna be complaining a little because it
still doesn't look as good as a lot of the.
Do
other
you remember
games
when they first went to like 3D with Samurai Showdown?
Yeah, and it was.
That's what this kind of reminds me of.
Well,
it's like
I mean,
they've done this before.
Drastic,
in 3D,
right?
Yeah.
But to me, it's just such a drastic leap from.
Well, the problem with it is honestly, because the thing about it is KOF has a very anime and a very artistic look to it, right? When you go to models, the hardest thing about models is you can't stretch things. And, you know, I've talked about this. Nikali, for example, he has both hair on 100% of the time. One set is just invisible.
Yeah, right.
It's just marked as invisible because transformation and that kind of stuff is harder in 3D models. The biggest problem with KOF is they're using the 3D models to make them look real and cartoony at the same time. So they're right in the middle. So it's that uncanny valley thing where they don't look cartoony enough and they don't look real enough. If they just went with the Exerd model.
Just that face alone right there.
Yeah, exactly.
They don't look like Shinkiro art, which, you know, that's...
Oops, like, I don't have it on the screen there properly. But if they just... I mean, you can see just this part.
It's scary.
Actually, you know what? The other one might work.
Well, and that's the thing. You're 100% right. I feel like they should use the Exard model, but I feel like it'll be a lot harder for KOF.
Right.
Only because they went the route of doing like the high detail, you know, 2D models with 13. So, I mean, I felt like that was fine because it looked beautiful.
Yeah.
And the fact that they're going this route is not bad, but like you said, there's a lot of characters that I'm wondering. I'm like, how is this going to mesh into your actual...
What's the game
really
going
to look? I mean, because the obvious advantage to it is you get more cinematic stuff. So the game looks a lot flashy. You get the zoom-ins on the characters. Like, you see Andy's super, where he's like... You know, like three elbow smashes at different angles and stuff. So you get a lot of those advantages in 3D. But I just wish that they would, like, really commit to one side or the other. But that character that I just showed on screen is named Muimui, I guess. Muimui. I'm pretty sure you have it right. I'm assuming she's Chinese, so I'm going to say Muimui because that's how you would pronounce
she's
it in Chinese.
She's from a Pachinko game, too.
Yeah, she's
from
a Pachinko
game.
Is that okay? Is this pachinko game fine?
Well,
I'm trying to figure out the rules here.
She doesn't have the mustache, or she doesn't have the messenger bag.
Right.
So, you know, it's not quite.
Because I'm trying to understand, like, you know, some are fine.
You'll never get it.
I guess you're
too young. It's okay.
That's okay. I can get that though.
Yeah, that's my girl.
So this is the scary part, right? I mean, look. Atlas, they're publishing KOF. Atlas is going
to
publish.
That picture is great. This picture's fine. Yeah, I can do
it. That picture shows up everywhere, right?
Yeah, that picture's fine.
Here we go.
Yeah, I'm about this picture.
Yeah, see, that picture is great.
No, if you scroll down, it's a bit better. There it is. Showing off 3D models. All right, I'm about that. That's cool.
3D models. But Atlas is going to be publishing it in the United States. And the interesting part is that it is promised to have improved online play.
Yeah, they all say that.
What does that even mean?
They all say that, and then plus, but the problem is that KOF 13's online play was pretty much garbage.
It's the worst, yeah.
So, like, improved online play can mean anything. It
can mean anything. You yeah. can, you don't have to worry about 95% of your matches dropping.
Yeah.
But they said, look, they said that Atlas listed a bunch of the features. They said there's going to be 50 fighters with movesets and more are rendered in full 3D graphics that preserves the essence of King of Fighters.
Whoa.
But they also said that it's going to have the best refinement since 98, which they said they're going to make sure the characters are super balanced.
Okay.
I mean, look, I can believe that because
we're
going to
make a video game and it's going to be good.
A lot of games, fighting games these days are really balanced now. Yeah. Like, I haven't thought, like, what's the most unbalanced fighting game that's come out recently? Like, nothing. Like, I can't even think of anything anymore.
I think
Mortal Kombat.
Well, DLC characters.
Mortal Kombat.
DLC.
Oh,
Alien.
God.
DLC characters, yeah.
But even with, like, as much as they patch Mortal Kombat, you know, it's always...
Yeah, they balance out. They balance it out in the end.
Yeah.
Injustice in 2013. That was so bad, man.
I don't know what
release Superman
but
was a
look,
character.
They are saying a lot of things like we're making this great. This is dangerous to do.
A lot of the people that are working on this game, they're SNK namestays. Like these are people that have been invested in the series. Whether it be on the program
the
side
over
or
from Capcom.
Yeah, they also
a battle director actually.
Yeah.
So I think, like, in all honesty, as much flack as I give the game for being kind of behind graphically, I know that I look at that game and you know that you're playing KOF. There's no question.
Yeah.
No matter who you are, no matter what you do, you see that the minute I look at a trailer, I'm like, dude, that is so KOF.
This
game
has been playable before. It was playable at E3, and I asked all the KOF players from here, from SoCal, that went to E3. And they're like, the game plays great.
But,
it looks funky, but it plays like KOF is what they all said. They're like, yeah, the game feels fine. Like, we're not worried about it.
I played it at PSX, and I mean, I wasn't thrilled with it, but it wasn't...
Yeah, it wasn't unbearable.
Like, the gameplay wasn't horrible.
Right.
I just think it looks weird.
Yeah, I don't know.
Sure. It's going to be one of those things that you're going to have to get over the way it looks, probably.
I feel like by the time we get it, and I'm giving them the benefit of the doubt.
We don't even have a release date yet or anything.
No,
it's coming
they just
out
said it's this
year.
Yeah. It's this year, but that obviously means that's anywhere between 1 month
like
and
December
8 months,
to 30th.
Right?
Yeah,
it's gonna come out December 31st.
Yeah.
Kind of like the Street Fighter V patch, Alex coming out in March, right?
I wouldn't be surprised if KOF got pushed into early next year. I wouldn't be surprised at all.
Because
graphically, like, they have, like, nice textures on everything, but, like, the character models themselves, they need so much work. They need so much work.
They got to announce 50 characters.
Yeah, I mean, in a bunch of...
I don't know. They're announcing them, like, 3 every week or something.
Yeah, I guess.
But Killer Instinct 3, Season 3, which I'm assuming you've been playing a lot of.
Nothing but.
they actually came out with a new patch recently.
Yeah.
Apparently they just fixed a bunch of little small bugs.
Right? Yeah, it's like if you pick Connor on the character select screen, you get the season 2 versions of all the characters. So they fixed that. No, that's not real.
I was about to say.
I'm making fun of Capcom because they still haven't fixed it. Anyway, Glacius's Shatter was... So they try to make it so that it hit landing frames.
Oh,
yeah,
landing
frames. They try to make it so it hit landing frames better or pre-jump frames better. And accidentally made it so that it was, like, inescapable in weird situations.
Right.
So that got fixed. Conrad had a weird bug thing that he was doing.
Right.
Where, like, if there was a certain interaction where if, like, certain projectiles hit, then, like, the game went nuts. It was weird.
But they haven't gotten rid of the level 4 enders yet, right?
No, in 3.01, they're giving the toggle so that you can have the Shadow Realm cinematic thing because I complained so much about it because Twitter is as PG as it gets. I cannot remember the last time I was that angry about something. I was like,
seriously.
I was like, look, I like them in the pachinko machines, but this background thing is the worst.
Like
some of them are so bad.
If you aggregated all of your tweets and had positive KI comments and negative KI comments,
it's like 4,
how
000.
Angry that you were, like, overrode all of the positivity.
It was like 50,000 to 1.
We can't even remember any of that
like,
positive stuff.
I'm like, yeah, KI is the best every single day. And then, like, I saw this change, and I was like, so that's not final, right? And they're like, no, that's final. And I was like, it's about to go down. Yeah. Let me tell you guys why this shit sucks. So I was like, look, this is whack, and that is whack, and this is whack, and that is whack. And I went to the forums, and I was like, this, this, and this. And they're like, next patch, we'll have a Switch. If you want to toggle it off, you can toggle it off. And I was like, best game.
And that's how it goes. And like, we're back.
And I was like, I'll see you guys next patch. Toggled off immediately.
I still don't even know why it was put in the first place. It didn't look very good.
So. Yeah, you know, we all make mistakes.
Yeah.
The game's great. I was like, man, this sucks. And they're like, we'll fix it for you. And I was like, nice. That's just nice. For thanks. Thanks for that, guys. You're real sweethearts. I mean, seriously, that's sick interaction. I was like, the developer came in there and was like, well, handle it, see.
I hope that it's cool, though. I mean, like, the fact that they actually listened and were like, okay, we'll just turn this off. They probably don't want to eliminate it because, like, that one or two guy who, like, thought it was the best
thing ever. There are guys that are saying that, yeah.
Right? So they're probably, like, the ones in Iron Galaxy, like, they don't want to hurt their feelings by just removing it completely. Because that guy's probably still like
working this.
You know, I like the artist a lot.
Get that Sage.
I know
man.
A lot
he
of.
He didn't make the game.
I know a lot of guys at IG. We've had, you know, they do good. They do good work. A lot of other things are great. Look at the models; they're so pretty.
Yeah.
And the stages, the lighting.
Like
beautiful.
I can honestly say, everybody.
Why would you hide
Galaxy
the lighting?
Is, they did an amazing job, especially when it came to the stage and graphical updates that they did.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like I like the fact that they're so actively changing.
Dude, they
things.
Also did graphical updates to Guilty Gear.
They did.
The characters get dirty. Yeah.
Oh my
and
god,
the lighting
it's so
is
sick.
So good now.
So like, let's just say if I throw like a purple fireball and it hits right here, the purple will flash to you guys.
Right. Exactly.
Because it's
what?
Actual light.
Yeah.
It's crazy. Uh-huh. And they're like 3D models.
That's crazy. That's been happening in KI since 2013.
That's nuts. Well, I mean, if it was a better game, I'd probably care. I'm joking, Steve.
My game's sick.
I like how he goes, my game's
sick. My game is sick. You guys know my game is sick.
That was a joke.
It's been happening
since 2013. I'm pulling it back.
Have you seen Glacius?
I'm pulling it back. It's alright. Glacius is cool.
Glacius is awesome.
He's
not as cool as he was in the original.
Oh god, he was so whack.
Oh my god.
The old games are terrible.
Yes, they are.
The old KI games are the worst.
KI, like, it's weird, but honestly, KI 1 looks like 10 times better than KI 2. KI 2 is so
KI
2
is the worst.
Horrible.
Those games are so bad. Everybody's,
I mean, that
like,
one should have been Clay Fighter, like, the sequel. Like, seriously.
Every time someone's like, yeah, I was a fan of the old games, and I was like, how?
Those games are so bad. You can't even look at them now and not be upset. You're
just,
like, what the hell is
they
this?
They have the benefit of being really loud.
Like, Ultra Combo!
It was legit, like you were in a party playing.
I used
playing
to work in an arcade, and Killer Instinct was up front.
Oh, yeah.
And I used to turn the sound down every day I came into work, and someone would come along and turn it back up.
Who would do a stupid thing like this?
Ultra! Yeah. Oh, so you worked at an arcade with Sejam then, right? Because he was turning it up, though.
No, dude. The
you
current,
were born at the
he
time.
Wasn't
I wasn't
born
yet.
Wow.
The current
a glimmer
games,
in your mom's eye. That's what you were.
The current game's music is so good, though.
Yeah,
it's the music
cool.
Like,
it's
when I'm just searching for a match, and, like, the background music is playing, I'm like, dang.
Dude, I'll tell you right now, KI did so good with the sound effects.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I love the music, I love the sound effects, like, I love Spinal's crunchiness. Like, I just
dude,
think it's, like,
I just like the fact.
Like, just when he laughs, and you hear that
noise
all over the place, he's so good.
Yeah, I'm
they
just
did
sad.
Such a good
matchmaking
job
is so fast, I don't get to listen to the music very long.
That's why I heard the same problem with Pockhead.
I
oh,
heard the
really?
Same thing actually. Yeah. True. Yeah. I've heard that Pokken's matchmaking is crazy good.
Yeah.
Pokken Tournament.
Pokken Tournament's
matchmaking. Exactly.
You know what? There's a lot of good fighting games out right now.
There's
yeah,
way
really,
too many.
Yeah.
Dude, there's so many.
Dude,
when
yeah,
Guilty Gear comes
like,
out,
we're back
I don't
in the 90s all over again.
Yeah. I've been playing nothing but Street Fighter, Killer Instinct, and MKX like crazy.
Well, I mean, you said it's like the 90s again, but the 90s, all those games were terrible. There was a lot of fighting games, but they were terrible. Now they're all like super good. Like these games are all super legit. Mm-hmm.
This is true.
I need to play Revelator.
Oh my god,
in any
so
case,
sick.
I want to play Sid.
Dude,
I know you're not going to want to be my friend after
no, it's
that,
cool. It's all right. It's all right. I can get mad later, but as long as you want to play, it's okay.
Oh, Sid is so sick.
I tried to learn
he
him,
eats?
But
oh, it's so
I
good.
Wanted to. But all I wanted to do was land combos with him. But he's not. He's more of a footsie, very.
Oh yeah,
I'm about
but
that
he's
life.
One of those.
Yeah.
Hey, guess what happened? You hit the wrong button. Counter hit. You just.
Oh
lost
yeah,
half
he
life.
Died. Yeah.
I'm about, that
but
is
I just kept
character.
Trying to land combos, all, so it wasn't the right character for me. But Johnny, I'm in there. In any case, that's all the topics that I had for today.
Oh, okay.
Do you guys have anything else that you wanted to talk about?
Off the top of my head.
Upcoming events?
Again, if you guys... Oh, we talked about upcoming events this weekend.
We talked about this weekend.
Yeah.
We don't talk about the future.
I didn't get a lot of other news outside of that Ultra Combo tournament.
Right,
so,
okay.
The World Cup.
That makes sense.
But in case you guys weren't here at the beginning when I introduced everyone, this is Bizarro Mike. He is the writer now for Yahoo Esports. He did all the casuals, articles on Red Bull. He wrote the Ricky Ortiz article on Playboy. This is Pasty Steve.
Sajam. Steve. Any of those things.
Sajam.
Fake
Superman,
Ultra David.
Superman Sajam.
Yeah, you can find my Twitter, twitter.com/Sajam. YouTube is Superman Sajam.
See, that's why it's awesome that we call him Super David, right? So when he was on the show, I even had a graphic for him. Like,
graphic is really good.
I don't know if I still have it up, but like I have it with like spray paint crossing out Ultra, and I like spray painted
Super.
Wow.
Oh, that's actually pretty
cool.
So we are Super Chen for the day?
Yeah, I was Super Chen
for
the day.
Cool.
That was
yeah.
sick.
Pretty cool.
And of course, this is also Steve. This is Tasty Steve.
Yeah.
That's it. Yeah.
I mean, yeah.
Best Zappa in the world.
Best Zappa in the world. Oh, I'm gone.
Next, dude, if we ever do this again, like, you're going to want to switch chairs. And
I got to
be
so far away.
We're
going
to let you two sit next to each other.
I got to walk around this table. I'm going to shake you.
Yeah, you two.
I am going to shake you.
You two can cozy up, and then me and David will sit over here and smirk and be jerks. That's
basically
what's going to happen.
Me and Tasty Steve are just going to be sitting like,
Guilty Gear.
Yeah, exactly.
Guilty Gear's sick. I watch Guilty Gear at all the tournaments. I don't know about this pachinko Zappa nonsense.
So wait. Okay, wait. I have a quick thing before we leave.
Okay.
You talk about how sick Killer Instinct music is.
Uh-huh.
Have you heard Guilty Gear music?
Guilty Gear's music is pretty insane.
Like, it is...
Anytime I see those videos where the characters are all clashing moves with Guilty Gear music in the background, I'm like losing my mind. I'm like, this is the sickest thing I've ever seen in my life.
So you know when Heavy Day first came out on Amazon, you could buy it as a single and it came with the karaoke version? On the few rare people who watch one of my karaoke streams, I sang that.
Are you serious? I bought that myself. It's on my phone right now.
Oh, yeah.
But that soundtrack is ridiculous. Like, it is so good. It blows my mind.
It's so good.
And nothing away from, you know, Killer Instinct.
I really like
that music, too.
I'm just saying, it's really good.
Killer, that's the old one.
You know what they have? That's like her theme has part of that.
Oh, does he?
They did the same thing that they do in Street Fighter where they remix it and they still have the original elements.
You know what I write to a lot is the Third Strike soundtrack.
Third Strike soundtrack has good. I think that might actually. Yeah, you know, my roommate loves 3S, right? But you know the intro where the announcer's like, select the one.
Yeah,
so
purposely,
the Street Fighter
rap.
I purposely screw it up.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
So instead of going 5, 4, 3, I say random numbers and it gets so mad. He's like, the numbers are, it's so easy to do. And I'm like, 7, 6, 9, 3, 4. And he's like, I hate you so much. And I'm like, yeah, that's sick. Third
Let's get it on down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6.
I'm just saying random numbers and stuff.
Dude,
here,
that is
so
that was like the perfect pump up music. Like when it happens, I was like, yeah. I'm about to play Street Fighter.
Third Strike is... The music is the best.
Yeah.
So
Third
good.
Strike music is amazing.
Dude, the new characters in KAI's music is really good, too. Kim Woo might have the best theme.
Kim Woo's theme is legit.
Kim Woo is...
What about Arbiter?
Arbiter's is good, too. It's got, like, the Halo orchestra, like...
Oh, really?
Choir thing going on.
I'd be down for that. I hate Halo, but I'd be down for that.
Damn!
That's right. Arbiter's from Hollow, right?
Yeah, he's from Hollow.
Okay.
Hollow Origins, get it right.
Yeah. The first Halo game, GoldenEye, that was my favorite. Halo GoldenEye with... the
Golden Gun?
Yeah, the AU gun, that was good. Yeah, I was a fan.
Were you alive when that was...
Maybe not.
Probably.
When did it come out?
97?
I think I was
in college when I was...
Wow, jeez. 97? Were you on this earth?
Yeah, I was.
Okay, just
I was
double
kicking.
96, 97.
I probably knew how to walk by then.
Probably.
That's how you know.
Okay, that's it for the Tuesday show. Thank you, everybody, for stopping in once again.
Time for food.
Mr. David was unable to attend today, but if you enjoyed what you saw, we have, you know, subscribe to our channel, follow our channel. Also, we've got Patreon links down here. But then also keep an eye out for Yahoo Esports content from Mike, and then Superman Sajam on YouTube with CJM, and you don't make content, so it's whatever. Yeah. So check out ArcadeShock.com.
Check out ArcadeShock and Split.
I just got silent buttons from him.
His Twitter's Tasty Great. Steve. You can follow him.
Oh, that's true. Follow me at Tasty_Steve. Yeah, and make sure you check out ArcadeShock. Yeah. Wait, Twitter? What are you at Bizarro Mike? Right?
No, Bizarro_ Bizarro. 1Z, 2 R's. Follow at Yahoo Esports also.
Okay.
Cool. Good stuff. Okay. Thanks everybody for tuning in. And any last words? Peace.